one in the class of Laplace transform. It is in the paper of Mathematics 2, paper code M201, in the module 4. In this module, we have already covered up almost all the applications and its properties related to Laplace transform. In this class, we are going to show that one problem in the form of improper integration is there. We are going to handle this that problem with the help of Laplace transform. It may not be mentioned in the question that using Laplace transform we have to do that, but just looking at the improper integration, its expression and its structure, we have to finalize that what are the properties we are going to use from Laplace transform to find out the result of that improper integration. It will help a lot. We are going to exhibit that. So let us start this. The first problem we are going to start this types of discussion is that simply it is given that evaluate 0 to infinity e to the power minus 4t sine square t by t dt. It is an improper integration. From the limit we can easily identify that, and look at this, nowhere it is having any clue that we are going to find out any Laplace transform. So it is simply a problem of improper integration, but from the structures, the basic functions, we have to identify that is it possible for us to tackle this improper integration by Laplace transform. Okay, so we are trying to start the problem from here. Zero to infinity e to the power minus st 1 by t into sine square t dt. If I start with this improper integration, can I write it as it is nothing but Laplace transform of 1 by t sine square t? Obviously yes, because we have multiplied this function by e to the power minus st and we have integrated it from 0 to infinity. So we can write that this integration is nothing but the Laplace transform of 1 by t sine square t. Now, keeping it aside, we are starting from this, that is sine square t, we can write it as half of 1 minus cos 2t. Then, we can find out Laplace transform of sine square t by the linearity property. We can write it here as half of Laplace transform of 1 minus half of Laplace transform of cos 2t. So it is nothing but half 1 by s minus s by s square plus 2 square, that is 4. So we can write now Laplace transform of 1 by t sine square t, that is division by t formula we are using, integration s to infinity 1 by 2 1 by s minus s by s square plus 4 ds. After that, we are going to use the concept of improper integration. So limit b tends to infinity, integration s to b half of 1 by s minus s by s square plus 4 ds. After that, we are putting the lower limit and upper limit after doing the result of integration. So we can write it as limit b tends to infinity half of log s minus half of log of a square plus 4. It is s to b. Just to keep the thing in a single page, I am trying to express the thing in the right hand side of the slide, that in the next line we can write it as limit b tends to infinity 1 by 4 log of, as it is 1 by 4 is taken, so it will be 2, then 2 will be coming in the power, so log of a square by a square plus 4 s to b. We are trying to solve this particular problem of improper integration, where this is a sub improper integration we are solving. So after substituting the lower limit and upper limit and finding out the limiting value, we will get the result as minus 1 by 4 log of s square by a square plus 4. Here one thing to be mentioned, that when we are putting the limit of b tends to infinity on logarithm has to be explained. Now once we got the result as like this, we can write it also as 1 by 4 log of s square plus 4 by s square. Next we can write it, now look at this, 0 to infinity e to the power minus st, that means in the left hand side I am writing the definition of Laplace transform, 1 by t sine square t dt is equal to 1 by 4 log of s square plus 4 by s square, and if I want to compare it with my requirement, the requirement is that in place of s, if we put 4, then this general result will be converted into the specific requirement of our problem. So putting s equal to 4, we get integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus 4t 1 by t sine square t dt is equal to 1 by 4 log of 4 square plus 4 by 4 square. So we are getting it as 16 plus 4, that is 20 by 4 square, that is 16. So 20 by 16, simplifying it, we can write it as log of 5 by 4. So finally what we get, the result of our given improper integration as this, where we have applied the Laplace transform and its properties for the result of this problem. So this is a huge application of Laplace transform in case of improper integration, in case of finding the result of improper integration. Next we are going for another problem where it is asked to find out the Laplace transform of, it is mentioned in the Laplace transform of t, integration 0 to t e to the power minus u sin u by u du. So let us check how we can find out the Laplace transform of this problem. It is not a difficult one. Now, if we can recall some standard result, we can get that Laplace transform of sin t by t is equal to cot inverse s. We have solved it various times in previous classes also, and we can use this result directly. Then by first shifting property, what we can write? Why we are using first shifting property? Because e to the power minus u is used here. So by first shifting property, we have Laplace transform of e to the power minus t sin t by t is equal to cot inverse s plus 1, here the value of a is minus 1. So in the next line we can write Laplace transform of 0 to t e to the power minus u sin u by u du is equal to 1 by s of Laplace transform of e to the power minus t into sin t by t, that means 1 by s of cot inverse s plus 1. But it is not our final requirement. We have the requirement along with this multiplied by t. So we can write Laplace transform of t into integration 0 to t e to the power minus u into sin u by u du is equal to minus d ds of 1 by s cot inverse s plus 1. So now we can just find out the result by differentiating this form, and differentiating this form will be only in UV form. So it is left for the viewer the detailed calculation. Just I am giving you the final result as s plus s square plus 2s plus 2 into cot inverse s plus 1 divided by s square into s square plus 2s plus 2. So this is our answer for this problem. Now we can go for another problem. Where the structure of the problem is that we have to prove integration t runs from 0 to infinity, integration u runs from 0 to t. I think all of you can identify that it is a problem of double integration. E to the power minus t sin u by u du dt. We have to find out the result of this one. Sometimes these types of problems are coming as proof that this equal to the result is given. Now here also, whenever we are seeing sin u by u form, we are starting with the structure that Laplace transform of sin t by t is equal to cot inverse s. So Laplace transform of 0 to t sin u by u du will be 1 by s of cot inverse is? Now by definition, Laplace transform of, now you please think about that. If I follow the definition of Laplace transform, the left hand side will give us integration t equal to 0 to infinity e to the power minus st, then ft dt, here ft is this one, so we can write it as u equal to 0 to t sin u by u du, then dt is equal to 1 by s cot inverse s. We have not yet in the exact form of our detailed requirement. Next we can write this as t equal to 0 to infinity u equal to 0 to t e to the power minus st sin u by u du dt is equal to 1 by s cot inverse s. Now the requirement is under double integration e to the power minus t sin u by u, and we got e to the power minus st sin u by u du dt. So in this expression, putting s equal to 1, if we put s equal to 1, we will get the desired structure. We get integration t equal to 0 to infinity, integration u equal to 0 to t. So look at this, it is a double integration of improper integration type. Still, we can very easily handle this problem if we are applying the properties of Laplace transform. So sin u I to the power minus t sin u by u du dt is equal to, in this right hand side putting s equal to 1, it is cot inverse 1, which is nothing but pi by 4. So apparently it is a tough problem, it is a big problem of improper integration of double integration type. But look at this, just by using some very basic properties and techniques of Laplace transform, we can find out the result of this improper integration. So this lecture was dedicated for improper integration calculation using Laplace transform, and we have exhibited some problems with some variations. You will get some more problems in these references, and also I am requesting you to find out the result of these integrations using the help of Laplace transform. Finally, I want to thank you all. Happy listening, happy learning.